This week we're going to begin a segment of videos talking about the sacraments. So most of it is actually coming from a book that's written by our founder of our religious order, Father Buela. The book is called Catechism for Youth. So we can begin with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Today we're going to be talking about the sacraments of initiation. All of the sacraments are sensible and efficacious signs of grace. They produce what they signify. And they were instituted by Jesus Christ in order to sanctify us. United with grace, they bestow or give to us the accompanying gifts and virtues. These are the gifts of the Holy Spirit, which we've talked about in the past, and the virtues, the cardinal virtues, remember those? In the Catechism of the Catholic Church, it teaches that Christ instituted the sacraments of the new law and that they are seven. Baptism, confirmation, the Eucharist, penance, the anointing of the sick, holy orders, and matrimony. The seven sacraments touch all the stages of life and all the important moments of Christian life. They give birth and increase, healing and mission to the Christian's life of faith. There is thus a certain resemblance between the stages of life, natural life, and the stages of the spiritual life. This is a really beautiful image to think about, to keep in mind, that Jesus Christ instituted the sacraments according to our way of life, so that the stages you see in natural life, watching your little brothers and sisters grow up, and that your parents saw when you grew up, Christ uses to show us our life, our growth in the life of grace. So in baptism, we're born, right? We're born into the life of grace. Holy Communion, we're nourished by Christ's body, which he's given to us as food, and at confirmation, we become adults, and so on and so forth. In today's lesson, we're just going to talk about the sacraments of initiation. Okay, those sacraments which incorporate or make us a member of the body of Christ.
Four of the seven sacraments can be received numerous times, meaning more than once. These four are communion, confession or penance, anointing of the sick, and matrimony, only in the case of the death of a spouse. Three of the sacraments can only be received once, and these are baptism, confirmation, and holy orders. These three are only received once because they leave an indelible mark on the soul, which is like a permanent seal, which nothing or no one can ever remove. In heaven, this mark will be a great cause of glory when we get there. And in hell, it will be a greater cause of confusion because it will remind us that while we could have been faithful, we betrayed Christ through sin. Consequently, it will remind us that instead of an eternity of glory, we must suffer an eternity of condemnation due to our own fault.
We are going to begin our lessons on sacraments with the beginning of the life of grace in every Christian. Baptism is the first sacrament of initiation and is the most necessary of all the sacraments. It makes us children of God, living temples of the Holy Spirit, meaning that the Holy Spirit dwells in us, and heirs of heaven. It also erases original sin, and if the baptized person is an adult, it erases all sins, either venial or mortal sins, as long as he is really repentant. This sacrament infuses the grace of God in our souls, along with its virtues and its gifts. Baptism is birth to the spiritual life. This is why Jesus teaches, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. In baptism, the water touches our body and the Holy Spirit transforms our soul. By baptism, we are grafted into Christ like branches on a vine and participate in his own divine life.
Baptism is so important and so necessary that without it, there is no salvation. This is why, in the case of danger, anyone can and must baptize, okay? An emergency baptism is done by pouring natural water over the head of the person being baptized and saying, John, or whatever the name is, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, with the intention of doing what the Church does. By baptism, we commit to live in a way that is worthy of Christ. We do this since, in a certain sense, we are other Christs. That's what we're called to be as Christians. By grace, we become another Christ in the world today. And since we are members of Christ's body, we must demonstrate by our way of life that Christ lives in us.
The second sacrament of initiation is confirmation. At confirmation, the Holy Spirit is given for the brave testimony of the faith. This means that we are given the gift to fearlessly declare that we are Christians and that Jesus Christ is our Lord and King. We are given the gift of faith just as it was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost, so that the Christians might boldly proclaim and confess Christ. The apostles were not content by the simple reception of the Holy Spirit. At the commandment of Christ, they communicated the Spirit to others by laying their hands on them. At the commandment of Christ, they communicated the Spirit by the laying of the hands. For example, when we read in the Acts of the Apostles that when the apostles found out that some of the disciples had only been baptized, they prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit. Then they laid their hands on them and they received the Holy Spirit. We find this in Acts chapter 8, verses 15 through 17. In other words, the apostles confirmed them. They laid their hands on them and they received the Holy Spirit. On the day of Pentecost, the apostles received the Holy Spirit and then immediately went out to preach the gospel to the whole world with all of their strength. Before receiving the Holy Spirit, on the other hand, they were cowards. They were afraid. They locked themselves in the upper room. They hid themselves because they were afraid of the Jews. We also are made valiant soldiers of Jesus Christ thanks to the Holy Spirit when we receive the sacrament of confirmation.
These two sacraments of initiation bring us into the Catholic Church, which is the true mystical body of Christ. The whole Church united with Christ form one whole body. We desire to love this Church. This is why you all are preparing for confirmation. To become an adult in the life of faith doesn't just mean a nice outfit of our fun party. Confirmation is not a graduation from the church of our catechism. It is a sacrament. And when we are confirmed, we are declaring for ourselves what our parents declared for us at our baptism. That we reject Satan, who is the devil, and all his tricks and lies. That we choose the path of Christ to try with all our strength to live and die as he did for the glory of his Father and for love of his brothers and sisters.
So we can end our lesson on baptism and confirmation, the sacraments of initiation, with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. We give thanks to you, Almighty God, Father, for the gift of our baptism. And we especially ask, O Holy Spirit, that you'll prepare our hearts, that you'll protect us from sin, so that when we're able to receive you in the sacrament of confirmation, we can receive you to the full. Empty our hearts and souls of sin and impurity, so that we may be full of you, O God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
So summing everything back up, today we talked about the sacraments of initiation, which are?
Baptism.
And confirmation.
These are only two of the seven sacraments, okay? So the next videos are going to continue talking about the sacraments. And next week we'll be beginning to talk about the sacrament of the Eucharist.
But next video we'll be focusing only on the Mass, okay?
Okay. So we'll see you next week. God bless.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Oh, I'm really impressed.